San Antonio, how are you? I'm getting lots of reports about being a light in our city. And boy, do we have two special people here with us on Beacon TV today. Hunter and Preston Wolfolk, the co-presidents of Documation here in San Antonio. And what an honor to have them on the program today, in particularly because of the heart that both Preston and Hunter have. And now that's been spread across an entire company. So all of Documation is on board with this sort of big C called community. So maybe you guys can speak to that first, and then we're gonna to explain to our audience how we're partnering up with the Beacon and what's gonna happen here at the end of November.
Thank you. Thank you for having us today. This is exciting.
Enjoy it.
Our mission is clear: character, community, customer. The customer is a given, being that we're in the technology business and service-wise. But the reason why we're partnering with this ministry and with the Beacon is because this totally aligns with our community piece. Mm-hmm. Very exciting. And I won't give it away because that's the excitement of the show.
Yeah. Go ahead. Talk a little bit about community.
About the community? Yeah. I believe that the big thing facing us right now is really the need out here in the community. We have a huge segment of our population here in San Antonio that's impoverished or just really underserved in general in our population, and a lot of those are children. We some of the pillars of our foundation at Documation have always been supporting education, supporting kids, supporting the betterment of our community.
Yeah, and the future generation, right?
Yeah.
Well, you touched on it. Let me read some statistics. This may surprise you, San Antonio. So we have, as of the latest community survey statistics, 1.48 million people living in our city. And this may surprise you, of that number, 257,000 people in San Antonio live below the poverty line. Of those 257,000, 97,000, a little less than half, are kids. So the Beacon had an idea. We're all about collaboration, partnership within the community, right? Two are better than one because they get a better return on their work. So we thought at the Beacon, what if we were able to write an article, locate different ministry outreach events that were happening across San Antonio, come together with a business like Documation, and do a giveaway? How can we raise money so that we can split whatever comes in between eight different ministries and give you, our listener, right, individually, or you as a business owner out there with a company, an opportunity to really make an investment in the future of our city? I want you to think with me just for a minute. So it's Christmas morning. You're at home. You wake up. There's no Christmas lights on the outside of the house. There's no Christmas tree in the living room. There are no presents. It's just another day, right, in the neighborhood. And how many children this year are gonna wake up to that reality? I mean, I don't know about you, our listeners, but that was not my experience at Christmas. You know, mom and dad got us up and there were always plenty of presents under the tree and the mood was bright, but that's just not true for a lot of the folks that are disadvantaged in San Antonio. And you know what, that's just unacceptable, right? It's just unacceptable. So there are some great ministries. I want to mention these ministries real quick that are reaching out into our community with Christmas outreach activities to share hope. Mm-hmm. You know, I think that's the big message, is how would it feel to still be this person, no tree, no presents, but somebody's reaching out to you with some love, mm-hmm, and wants you to know that we care. We care about you, not only at Christmas, but throughout the year.
Yep.
And be able to, the greatest gift I think they can give in that case is the hope.
Yeah.
And then to be able to share the real meaning of Christmas with these same people, that Jesus came.
Yes.
And we're celebrating his birthday.
Yeah.
And his entrance into the world, yeah, right? Here are the eight ministries that we've selected. The first is the Dream Center on the west side. That's Pastor Warren Beamer that leads up that effort. Doing amazing things, had a building donated over on the west side, working with about 500 families in that area of the city. Last Chance Ministries here in San Antonio, Pastor Jimmy Robles. Wow, what he's got, I guess, 30 different leaders now, all in tune with youth and food pantry and even a biker ministry, right, on the west side. You know, Jimmy's heart is really for those people that other people have just forgotten about.
Yeah.
Right? Thus the name, Last Chance Ministries.
Yeah.
And so he's really got some awesome things going on in his Christmas outreach event, Moment of Truth Ministries with Bill Morgan over on the east side. This will be their 11th year of celebrating what they call Happy Birthday Jesus. And so lots of kids involved in that, 125 different kids that they're going to serve through their outreach. Mark Lugo Ministries will be working on the south side of San Antonio and the surrounding area. Mark has worked with the Somerset High School trustees there, and they ended up giving him the football field for his outreach. So they're going to turn that into a winter wonderland and serve 1,000 kids out in the Somerset area. Agora Ministries, again, on the west side. They're doing a couple of things, primarily partnering with local schools so that they make sure that these students do get toys on Christmas. But again, there's that word partnership, right, and collaboration. Victory Outreach, prostitutes need Christmas too, right? So they're really reaching these women that are out on the streets, doing the best they can to provide for their family that do have kids. And how do we bring them in and let them know that they're loved, right? And that their life could be changed, given a chance. His Bridge Builders on the west side again. I believe this is their, 19th of December is their event. It's a Christmas block party. They'll have over 200 families that they're serving. And then finally, the Cam Christmas Shop, the Christian Assistance Ministry downtown. I know that's near and dear to you guys' heart. They're giving a free shopping experience for families, again, who may not be able to afford Christmas otherwise, but they can go to Cam and pick out some presents and some gifts and be able to have some things under the tree. And look, at the end of the day, the Beacon, I know Documation as well, our hearts are, boy, we want people to know about Jesus. And so, these are fun activities, and Santa shows up, and gifts are always a part of Christmas. But these activities are really used to really share the truth of why Christ came, was born, lived here 33 and a half years, sacrificed himself. Here's the bottom line. Jesus is the reason for the season, right? And you can bet that all eight ministries are going to make sure that the people they're serving are aware of that very fact. So eight ministries across the city. How would you feel if you could give one gift, right, as a year-end gift, a special? God's blessed you this year and your family, and you're going to have a wonderful Christmas and lots of things under the tree. But what if you could write one check, one gift, and literally touch almost our entire city? Because that gift is going to be split between all eight ministries. Now, our goal for this is $40,000. We have a desire in our heart to write a $5,000 check to each of the eight ministries. We need you to respond quickly, because November 23rd is sort of when we're asking for your gift to come in. They're already planning these events. There's already expenses being incurred. So the quicker that we can get people to donate, I think the better. So this is an opportunity for you. Documation said, hey, we want to partner with the Beacon. We want to sponsor this article and get it out because of our hearts. And so tell me just a little bit about why Documation is on board.
I think the big reasons here, if you get core to the Christian faith, if you get down to the basic fundamentals, it's taking care of the least among us, right? Those that need help. Not everybody can lift themselves up on their own. It's not always possible. And our company was founded originally based on philanthropy. It was founded based on how can we take what we do well and give back to the community. And we're not always going to get it right. We can't be a perfect company. We can't provide everybody perfect service or a perfect experience. But if possible, from the top down and then from the bottom up, how does our company say that our focus is community? Our focus is to take what we've been given and give back and bless others with that.
That's awesome.
What's good for San Antonio is good for all of us. What's good for our city, what's good for our kids, what's good for our families, is good for our business. And it's somewhere we want to raise our kids. We want to make sure we have strong families. And we can only do that by helping San Antonio.
Well, and it's not just with the Beacon. Hunter, do you want to talk to our audience a little bit about DocuElves and what you guys are doing there?
Yeah, we have a neat experience. Once a year, we're Christmas time, we give to roughly 80 families a month and a half worth of food and supplies. And a ministry helps us become aware of families that might be homeless that day, children at the school districts that are the most needy. And we show up, our employees volunteer their time and their weekend, and they take big truckloads. An entire truck full or car full will feed that one family, and that's how much food and gifts is in that. And it's a special experience to really see firsthand and be serving face to face. And I gotta let you know, I love what y'all are doing here. You are one ministry that's pulling together so many ministries and helping companies like us or individuals like us be able to bless so many thousands of families and covering the entire city. You've done your homework. You know these people personally. You know their hearts. You know their missions. You know where the money is going, and you've made sure that we're being wise stewards of our money. As we bless through one, you're going to funnel those out to the right places.
Yeah.
Well, and we couldn't do it right without documentation and your help and the partnership and the sponsorship that you gave to be able to get this news out to our community, right?
Yeah.
So the Beacon, sure, most people have heard of the Beacon magazine, right?
Yeah.
But we have other opportunities for exposure. We've got Beacon TV, which we're listening to today, Beacon Radio, you know, E-News Blast. You need to go to the Beacon, sabeacon.com, and sign up for regular updates where we're sharing about the amazing things that some of these nonprofit leaders are doing across the city and God's activity across San Antonio. Wouldn't it be cool if San Antonio really became the first transformed city in the nation and set up as a model, a light on a hill for other cities across the nation?
Yeah.
And listen, with guys like you and Documentation on board, we got a shot, right? We got a shot. Come on, Holy Spirit, right? I do want to ask one other question. Because I'm thinking about this, because we really want to get creative with this giveaway. And sure, you can, as an individual, write a check. Maybe your family all pitches in. I don't know if you give allowances to your kids, but maybe they give back a little bit of their allowance.
Right. Yep.
And you give a family check, and that's awesome. And that's probably going to be the majority of the gifts that we get. But I know there are businesses out there, too, who really are listening to you guys going, man, we need to be doing some of this, right?
Yeah.
And so wouldn't it be cool if that business could get together and really challenge their employees? Hey, we're going to do a love offering, right, to be able to give back to our city this year.
Yeah.
This is the day that it's going to happen on, and everything that you guys give, we're going to give to the Beacon and their Christmas giveaway to touch an entire city.
Yeah.
You know, are you in, employees, kind of thing. So I don't know if there's any challenge that you may want to make to business owners.
Well, I would say, too, culture is everything to us at Documentation. And our people, we don't have a problem with tenure. We keep people. People love where they're at. We love where we're at. And part of it is because we have purpose. And doing this, getting on this bandwagon with your employees and allowing them to have a way to have purpose this season and get to bless children, bless families, and do it through a ministry that's already made sure they're going to being wise stewards of their money, going to the right places. This is really neat.
Yeah, I agree.
You know, I think what I just heard, right? What we'll hope is the Holy Spirit, not the fact that I hadn't had lunch yet. But what I just heard is we need to do a follow-up video. So if you're out there and you're listening and you're entrusting us with a gift that really is literally going to go touch thousands of people in the community, we need to come back and report to you that investment and the return on investment, you know, by talking to the leaders of these eight different ministries and perhaps even some of the people that were changed.
Yep.
By that generosity. So you're going to want to stay tuned, San Antonio. Well, where do you go, right? At the end of the day, how do you give a gift? We've got a webpage set up at sabeacon.com. You can go there and find that webpage. I've got the whole address here. Hang on for me one sec.
Hey, and I've got the challenge. The challenge is,
there we go. Come on.
Businesses, get on board. Let's all do this together for our city. Let's bless a bunch of children. Let's bless a bunch of families and have a lot of fun at it. What a fun way to get your Documentation, your work family all together and change some people's lives.
Yeah, it's pretty easy. Our employees, we love to match. So we say whatever they're going to raise, the company is going to match. And we love to see what our employees can come up with on their own. And I think...
Man, that may scare you here with the employees.
I know, right? Well, yeah.
It's like, okay, we're going to make them go broke Christmas.
That's a good problem to have, though. That'd be the best problem to have, that. But, you know, I think most of them are waiting to be organized. I think they're waiting for somebody to say, it's just a call to action. It's just a push or a gentle nudge. We don't like to force anything on anybody. We love to give them the opportunity. So we really urge others to be able to try to create opportunity for your employees to give back.
It's great that you made it so easy. HR managers, just go to sabeacon.com, get with you, and Simple as it?
Yep. Click the button on the sabeacon.com page. There'll be a gift button at the top. I think it's / Christmas blessing. Yep. That's always hard to remember, the forward slash. Just go to sabeacon.com,
yep,
and there'll be instructions on that page for you guys to be able to help us reach our goal of $40,000,
yep,
between November the 1st and November the 23rd. So we don't have long. Don't wait on this. Take action in your companies today based on the challenge that Hunter and Preston gave. Come on, let's change some lives here in San Antonio. Let's make this Christmas not just the best Christmas because of the hope and the generosity of our city, but because hundreds of people come to know Jesus as their Lord and their Savior this Christmas.
Yeah.
SABeacon.com. Thanks for listening.
Yep.
We're going to do an update. Stay tuned.